فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
And what did he do? Wasakata. He went quiet. Sharif became quiet because he's letting for the people to write. So he went quiet. لِيَكْتُبَ الْمُسْتَمْلِي, so those who are listening, who are dictating, so they can write. فَلَمَّا نَظَرَ إِلَى ثَابِتٍ. Remember, Sharif he narrated the hadith. Are you all with me? He narrated the hadith. Everyone is writing the chain of narration. He's waiting for the people to write. As he's waiting for the people to write, Thabit ibn Musa Zahid, who was known for his ibadah, entered. He entered and he walked in. When he walked in, Shariq ibn Abdullah al-Qadhi saw him. And he looked at him and he said to him, Man kathurat salatuhu bil-layli, anyone whose prayer becomes a lot at night, ha, hasuna wajhuhu bin-nahari, his face becomes gloomy and beautiful at daytime. Ha. Who was he referring to? He was referring to Thabit, and he was talking to Thabit. And he was addressing the matter to Thabit. Some of the people thought that was what the Prophet ﷺ had said. So they were writing it on the hadith. What were they doing? So what's that called? That is called Mudraj al-Isnadi. The second one is Mudraj al-Matni. Idraj happening to the Matn. So what happened right now? Thabit, when he came in, he himself didn't know. So what did he do? He used to narrate the hadith with the chain of narration like that. So whenever he went somewhere, he would narrate it. What had happened, right? What mixed up now? Did the hadith mix up? The chain got mixed up. This chain is not for this hadith. The Prophet ﷺ did say that. But it's another chain for it, not this chain. So idraj happened to this chain of narration. The other one is, and it happens, somebody's narrated a hadith and something occurs and he looks at that something and it comes back and this is what happened. The other one is what? Idraju al-matn. The mudraj happens to that. مَا أُدْخِلَ فِي مَتْنِ مَا لَيْسَ مِنْهُ. It is to enter something into the matn bila faslin, without any fasl, and it's three types. It is three types. Okay? It is to enter the matn, something part of the Prophet's speech, when the person is trying to say something else. But something enters it, it enters it, without him saying, stop, and he says something. Carry on. He doesn't say that. So he enters it. It occurs in three ways. It occurs, أن يكون الإدراج في أول الحديث. It is at the beginning of the hadith. Right at the beginning. And that's very little. It happens very little. The second one is what? The second one is أن يكون الإدراج في وسط الحديث. That the إدراج occurs when? In the middle of the hadith. And that is lesser than the first one. It happened in the middle, is more less than even the first one. The third one is the most, which is أن يكون الإدراج في آخر الحديث وهو الغالب. And this is the majority of times. It happens at the end. Because the scholars of hadith don't tend to talk whilst they're narrating a hadith. But they do it when they finish. Remember, they don't tell the people, I've stopped the hadith, and they carry on. So they just, when they finish the hadith, they keep talking. People still think that he's narrating the hadith. Huh? They think. We took one hadith, inshallah, for all of you to remember. Is that what Imam al-Khatib narrated? من رواية أبي قطن وشبابه وشبابته فرقهم عن شعبة عن محمد بن زياد عن أبي هريرة عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم that the messenger said أسبغ الوضوء ويل للعقاب من النار. The hadith أسبغ الوضوء is from the speech of Abu Huraira. It's مدرج من كلام أبي هريرة. As Imam al-Bukhari رحمه الله his other narration, it clarifies. Abu Qatlin is the one who made the mistake. That example is when it happens at the beginning of the hadith. Because Asbigh al-Wudu'a is not the Prophet's speech. The Prophet's speech is what? Waylu lil-aqabi min al-nar. So it happens at the beginning. The evidence happening in the middle is the speech of what? Hadith Aisha, in the narration of how this revelation started, she said, كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يتحنت في غار حراء وهو التعبد الليالي ذوات العدد. She said that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم used to sing, he used to go out the nights or in the nights to غار حراء. And then Aisha wanted to explain to the people, sorry. كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يتحنث في غار حراء. الإمام الزهري came and he added the word in the middle to explain to the people what it meant. كان يتحنث. ومن تحنث what is تحنث me some people may not understand. So he said وهو التعبد الليالي ذوات الأسباب. الليالي ذوات الأسباب was there, but in the middle he added that not because he was trying to put in the hadith, but he was explaining it to the people, but the people didn't distinguish between it. The third one is مثال وقوع الإدراج في آخر الحديث. It happening at the ending of the hadith, and that is the hadith where the Prophet said أبو هريرة للعبد المملوك أجراني. The slave that is owned, he has two أجر. والذي نفسي. So that's the hadith. It's finished there. But والذي نفسي بيدي لولا الجهاد في سبيل الله والحج وبر أمي لأحببت أن أموت وأنا مملوك. والذي نفسي بيدي I swear by the one whose soul my hand is in, my soul his hand is in. All of that is Abu Hurairah's speech. The hadith is only للعبد المملوك أجراني. What causes hadith إدراج to happen to the hadith? الدواعي الإدراج. What are the causes? Causes. There are many causes. The most famous of them is بيان حكم الشرعي. The first one is for the person wants to clarify a ruling. So the hadith, by accident, it will enter into it. He's trying to explain a hadith to the people. The second one, استنباط حكم الشرعي من الحديث قبل أن يتم الحديث. The second one is he's trying to extract a ruling. The first one, he's trying to clarify a ruling. That's the first one. The second one is trying to extract a حكم شرعي from the hadith before he finishes the hadith. The third one is شرح لفظ غريب في الحديث. He's trying to explain a strange word in the hadith which people may not know. How is a hadith which is مدرج recognized? How is it recognized? There are many ways. One of the ways to recognize a hadith is مدرج is ورود الحديث منفصلا في رواية أخرى. The hadith, it comes separated from this particular speech, is separated from it in other narrations. Scholars will say, it's مدرج. Second one is تنصيص عليه بعض الأئمة المطلعين. Some of the scholars who observe and who know this science very well will say that this is a مدرج, who are known for their knowledge of this. They will say it. Number three, إقرار الراوي نفسه. The narrator, he himself would admit to it. He himself would admit to it. أنه أدرج هذا الكلام, that he added that word into the hadith. Last but not least, استحالة كونه صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول ذلك. That it is impossible that the messenger would say this. Because remember the hadith of Abu Huraira right now that I just showed you, where he said, فَوَلَّذِي نَفْسِ بِيَدِي I swear by the one whose soul my hand is in. If it wasn't for jihad fi sabili Allah and hajj and the obedience of my mother. The Prophet wouldn't say the obedience of my mother. So the scholars, that's of course, it's somebody else. And I would love to die as a mamluk. I would love to die as a mamluk. The Prophet ﷺ wouldn't ask for that. What is the ruling of a hadith which is idraj? Idraj is haram. بإجماع العلماء, with the consent of the scholars. From the muhadithin and from the fuqaha. ويستثنى من ذلك, an exception is given to that. ما كان لتفسير غريب, as long if it's to explain a wording which is غريب. This is not prevented. It's not prohibited. And that is why Zuhri did it, and other than them he did it. The best book to read in this matter is الفصل للوصل المدرج في النقل by خطيب البغدادي رحمه الله تعالى. Also there's a book Ibn Hajar رحمه الله wrote, it's called تقريب المنهج بترتيب المدرج, and it's a summarized from the book of خطيب البغدادي by Ibn Hajar رحمه الله تعالى. Then Ibn Hajar رحمه الله he says أو بتقديم أو تأخير. If the mukhalafa, the second type of mukhalafa, which is what? Taqdeem or ta'khir. It's to put something forward and to delay something. Meaning, it's to put back to front something, to turn over something. It's called maqloob. The second type of mukhalafa, I said it's five types. The second type is al-maqloob. Maqloob is ismu maf'ool, and it's from the word qalb. It's qalbi. If you take your jumper right now and you wear it inside out, it's called maqloob, inside out. اصطلاحا it means ابدال, to exchange لفظ a word بآخر, another word, في سند الحديث, in the chain of the hadith, or متنه, or in the wording of the hadith, بتقديم, by putting one before the other, أو تأخير أو delay. So, from that definition, we can find out that the types of مقلوب there are is two types. مقلوب, which is a سند, and مقلوب المتن. The مقلوب that occurs in the chain of narration, and the مقلوب that occurs inside the متن. مقلوب السند is what? It has two forms, or two ways in which it occurs. Which is two ways it occurs. Which is called, it's called مقلوب في الإسنادي. And it has, وَهُوَ مَا وَقَعَ الْإِبْدَالُ فِي سَنَدِي. It is what the exchanging occurs in the chain of narration. And it has two ways in which it's known. أَنْ يَكُونَ الْحَدِيثُ مَشْهُورًا بِرَاوٍ. It is that the hadith is famous with a narrator. It's famous. بِرَاوٍ فَيَجْعَلُ مَكَانَ آخِرِ فِي طَبَقَتِي. So the person exchanges or places in the place of that person, in that place of that person who's known, from another person who's at the same tabaqa of him, same level as him. For example, Salim, who did he narrate from? Salim always, we find out inshallah, Salim is always one of the narrators that read from Abdullah ibn Umar. Who is another person that many people mix up and they always exchange him with? Nafi'. So Nafi' and Salim, both, who do they narrate from? And Abdullah ibn Umar. So exchanging Nafi' with Umar, ibn Umar, Nafi' with Salim with Nafi' or Nafi' with Salim is called مقلوب الإسناد. That's one form. That's one way. The second one is أن يكون القلب بتقديم وتأخير في رجال الإسناد. Or it can be that in the chain you put a person, his name back to front. For example, his name is Ka'ab ibn Murrah. You make it Murrah ibn Ka'ab. And they're two different men. So you say Ka'ab ibn Murrah or Murrah ibn Ka'ab. That's called Qalbu. It's to change his name back to front. The second one is Al-Qalbu fil Matn. That the qalb, it occurs, it happens in the matn of the hadith. And that is very famous, which is the hadith narrated by, Imam Muslim on the authority of Abu Hurairah, on the seven people who are going to be shaded the day of judgment. The Prophet said, سَبْعَةٌ يُظِلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظِلِّهِ يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلُّهُ. Seven, Allah is going to give them a shade the day of judgment when there is no shade. There's a mistake that occurred in one of the narrations, which is what? رَجُلٌ تَصَدَّقَ بِصَدَقَةٍ. A man, he gives a charity, صَدَقَةٍ. فَأَخْفَاهَا, he hid the charity. حَتَّى لَا تَعْلَمُ يَمِينَهُ, until his right hand doesn't know مَا تُنْفِقُ شِمَالَهُ, that which his left hand gave. Ooh. It was meant to be what? That his left hand is unaware of what his right hand gives. What happened? Turned around. Maqlub. Qalb of happened to the hadith. It should have been حَتَّى لَا تَعْلَمُ شِمَالَهُ. His left is unaware of مَا تُنْفِقُ يَمِينُ, that which his right gives. Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, and I don't want to go into too much details, but he also did, he said that the hadith where the Prophet ﷺ, he said, لَا يَبْرُكْ أَحَدُكُمْ كَمَا يَبْرُكُ الْبَعِيرُ وَلِيَضَعْ يَدَاهُ قَبْلَ الرُّكْبَتَاهُ. He said that this hadith is maqlub. That the Prophet said, don't go down the way that the right the camel goes down. Ibn al-Qayyim said, in Izadul Mi'ad, fi hadi khayr al-ibad, he said that the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't go down the way that the camel goes down. Go with your hands first and then your knees. That's what the Prophet said. He said that the hadith is maqlub. It should have been go down with your knees before your hands. It's what Ibn Qayyim mentions in his kitab, Zadul Ma'ad. But it's very weak, and scholars have refuted him, and they mentioned that is a misunderstanding of his side. Na'am. What are the causes that make a hadith become maqlub? What are the causes? Sorry, I've left a third type. I mentioned two types. Al-Qalbu fil Isnadi. The second one is Al-Qalbu fil Matni. The third one is Al-Qalbu في السند والمتن معا, both of them. And all of you guys, I don't need to explain it to you guys, but it's what the people of Baghdad tested Imam al-Bukhari with, what they did to him when they gave the hadith to him. they changed the chain and the matin for him. So they changed the matin with the chain and hadith. So what did they do? They done قلب المتن والإسناد. They changed the matin and the isnad for him. Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah. And why did they do that? They did that امتحانا لحفظه, to test his memory. فرد على ما كانت عليه قبل القلب. What did Bukhari do? He brought all of the chains of narration in its correct form. ولم يخطئ في واحد منها. And he did not do any mistake in that matter. Anyone who wants to see that story in details, he can go to the Kitab تاريخ بغداد لإمام الخطيب البغدادي رحمه الله, the second volume, page 20. Second volume, page 20. Bukhari رحمه الله story is well written there. When they all sit him down to see his memory. And that which they did to him is called what? قلب المتن قلب السند والمتن. نعم. What is the ruling of the hadith? Sorry, what are the causes that, يرحمك الله, what are the causes that cause قلب? What are they? The reasonings, brothers, differ. تختلف الأسباب التي تحمل بعض الرواة على القلب. There's a lot of reasons that make narrators fall into this reason. One is قصد الإغراب. He intends to be strange, awkward, so people can take narrations from him. His intention is to be somebody who's unique, who's come with something unknown and unseen before. لِيَرْغَبَ النَّاسُ, so the people can, you know, want في رواية حديثي, to narrate his hadith. وَالْأَخْذِ عَنْهُ, and to take from him. The second one is قَزْدُ الْإِمْتِحَانِ, the intention is to test, such as that which was done to Imam al-Bukhari. They only did that to test him. Not that the chain of narration was like that. It was to check من حفظ المحدثي, to check the person's memory. وتباب ضبطه, and his complete comprehension of the memory he has. The third one is الوقوع في الخطأ والغلط من غير قصده. He fell into a mistake unintentionally, and he didn't intend it. It wasn't his intention. What is the ruling of the hadith of qalb? What is the ruling? If فإن كان القلب بقصد الإغراب, if the reasoning of why the qalb occurred is because the person wanted to make the people see him in a strange way and an amazing, unique person, and that was his reason, فلا شك في أنه لا يجوز, then there's no doubt that it is not permissible. That one is because that can fall under, because that's the actions of the wadda'een, those who place the hadith. And that's changing the hadith. That's not allowed. وَإِنْ كَانَ بِقَصْدِ الْإِمْتِحَانِ, but if the intention is to test, فَهُوَ جَائِزٌ, it is permissible, لِلْتَثَبُّتِ مِنْ حِفْظِ الْمُحَدِّثِ, to verify the memory of the narrator, وَأَهْلِيَتِهِ, and whether he is an entitled person for this science and this field. But with the condition, even that person who is testing, he has a condition. بالشرط أن يبين الصحيح قبل الانفضاض من المجلس. He has to give the correct way before they leave the gathering. He has to give the right chain of narration and the right metan and bring them back together before they leave the gathering and where they're sitting. وإن كان عن خطأ وسهو. The third one is if it was done by a mistake. And it was by accident. فلا شك في أن فاعله معذور في خطأه. Without a doubt, then the person, of course, he's forgiven for that which he didn't intend and he done by accident. لَأَنَّ إِذَا كَانَ لَكِنْ بَتْ إِذَا كَثُرَ ذَلِكَ مِنْهُ, but if that becomes a lot, that he's doing these مَقَلْب a lot and it's occurring a lot from him, فَإِنَّهُ يُخِلُّ بِالْطَرْطِهِ, this will affect his memory, وَيَجْعَلُهُ ضَعِيفًا, and it can make his narration weak. Can make his narration. As for, what about the hadith which is مَقْلُوب? It is from the ahadith which are weak. كما هو معلوم, as it's known. وذلك لأنه مخالف, مخالفة, مخالف للرواية الثقات, because it's an opposition of the narrators who are reliable. The best book for this field is the book written by Imam al-Khatib al-Baghdadi. He called it رافع الارتياب في المقلوب من الأسماء والألقاب. And he did that just for the narrators who, like I mentioned before, Ka'ab ibn Murrah and Murrah ibn Ka'ab, that people mixed up and they got it wrong. He goes and he goes, like, for example, Imam Malik, rahimahullah, what's his name? Malik ibn Anas. Put Anas before Malik, what does it become? It became the name of a companion. So people who got those type of names wrong and mixed it up, he, rahimahullah, he explains it. Naam.